Hi guys, this is Bart with Paria Outdoor Products, and today I want to go over our Tri-Fold Carbon Cork trekking poles. So when we designed these poles, we had kind of three things in mind. We wanted to make them compact and lightweight so that you could stash them in your backpack, make it easy to bring along, and so they're always available for you to use. The second thing, we wanted to make them durable. So we use carbon fiber materials along with aluminum to make them strong, make sure that they last for plenty of hikes. And then finally, we wanted to make them adjustable so that you could make them longer or shorter to leverage them on steep climbs, or if you're going on long descents, you take pressure off your knees. And then finally, the mission of our company is really to make products that are accessible to everyone so that everyone can get out there. They're affordable and get out on the trail and use them. All right, so to get started, each one of these comes in their own nylon storage bag. So you want to go ahead and take them out. And they're initially bundled with this Velcro, kind of keep them together. Go ahead and undo that. And then, you're welcome to kind of toss it, or if you want to just bundle it up again. I like to keep it on there just so because I do kind of bundle them together when I'm not using them. But if they get in your way because of the hand, you grip the handle down here, then go ahead and take those off. And probably the easiest thing to do is just to kind of let them hang free like this. So they're basically made out of three sections. There's this one, and then there's actually a third one that's inside the handle. So the easiest thing is just to assemble these two lower ones and then grab the bottom of this third one that's inside, slide it down, get it in here, and then continue to pull. And then the internal steel cable that's in there, as you pull, you're going to tighten it up. And then there's this locking button that you have to pull out to and then rotate it to the locking position. And then that gets the pole locked. Once it's in there, it's solid. It's not going to go anywhere for you. So that's kind of the trick, is to get that assembled. And then to break it down, really you just pull out slightly, rotate it to the unlock, and then you're able to push that third section inside, and then it allows you to break the rest of it down, just like that. So, it does take a little bit of practice the first time around, but once you get it figured out, it's pretty easy. It goes together pretty quickly, just like that. And then lock it into position, and then you're good to go. The adjustments is just via this flick lock right here. So, this is pretty standard. Just open it up, adjust it to whatever length you want, lock it back up. You want to kind of have it at a 90 degree angle generally when you're hiking. And then, want to make it longer when you're going downhill so you can kind of push down on it. And then if you're going uphill, you might want to shorten it up a tad and then maybe grip it down here just so you can get good leverage. If for some reason this is a little loose, there's this metal locking nut right here that you can tighten up just to make it really snug so that it's not going to go anywhere. So if you need to make an adjustment, just tighten up the nut right there. And then finally, to adjust the strap, what you want to do is you want to make sure that the strap goes in from the bottom. You always want to get your hand in from the bottom and then just grip it like that. Don't go like this. What tends to happen is if you get it tight like that and you happen to fall, you could injure your thumb that way. The other benefit too is if you get it like this is, if you want to let go of them because you want to grab a snack or take a picture or something, they'll just kind of hang free and then you'll get them right back like that. To adjust the length, you want to grab the free end right here, pull out just a tad, and there's this wedge in here that kind of keeps the strap in position. So get it kind of, once you get that wedge out, you can kind of adjust it. And then when you get it at a length that you like, just push it back inside, and and then it's good. Generally, once you adjust it one time, you won't have to do it too many other times. So get that wedge in there, lock tight, and then it should be good to go. So lastly, I want to talk about the tips. So the poles come with these carbide tungsten tips, which are real durable, and they're probably your best option if you're out on the trail. They're going to give you the best traction, best support. If you're in kind of muddy areas or snow, you want to attach these trekking baskets. They just thread right on like that. And then that way, your tips aren't going to sink into the ground because the baskets are going to prevent them. And then finally, they also come with these rubber feet. And so these are really primarily for concrete if you're out on walks on concrete trails, just because they protect the carbide tip. It'll wear out on concrete if you use it. It's not really designed for that. So for that, you want to put the rubber tips, and they just go on right that real snug. And that's it. So, yeah, thanks for checking us out, and happy hiking.